Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the final installment of Behind the Bench. Let's hit the field one last time. The Bearcats got the last laugh against Texas Southern this season, avenging a 5-4 loss last month as they picked up a 9-1 victory in run rule fashion Wednesday night at the Bearcat Softball Complex. The Bearcats' 18-26 were powered by 2 4-run innings and 10 hits to pick up run rule victory over the Tigers 17-10-1. Sandyson's 10 hits were spread by 7 different Bearcats, led Katie Andre, who totaled 3 hits in her 3 at-bats while also driving in 3 RBI. Tiffany Thompson was the only other Bearcat with a multi-hit game on a 2-for-4 night in which she sent the ball over the outfield wall in the 5th inning for her 6th homer of the season. Bearcat starter Annie Bailey pitched the complete game to the Bearcats to pick up her 6th win on the year of the night when she allowed 2 hits and struck out 6. Meanwhile, the Lady Tigers used 5 different arms on the night, with Bailey Daniels picking up the loss on a night in which she saw 1.1 innings of action and allowed 3 earned runs off of 2 hits. Offensively, Texas Southern saw little success, with the lone bright spot coming in the 2nd inning thanks to a long ball by cleanup hitter Danielle Saunier, her 2nd of the 2018 campaign. Brooke Malia had 3 extra base hits, but a late homer by Adeline Christian was all that the Wildcats needed for a 2-1 win over Sam Houston State on Saturday afternoon at Poly Wells Park. The freshman second baseman accounted for the Bearcats' only run of the game with a solo homer off ACU starter Hannah Knoll, with 1 out in the 4th. However, the Wildcats' Brianna Barnhill did better with a 2-run shot with 1 out in the 6th to propel ACU to the win. The Cats got a hit in each of the first 3 innings, including extra base hits from Malia and Cody Carpenter, but was unable to get on the board until the 4th. That's when Malia launched a 0-1 pitch over the right center field fence off of Knoll, pulling the Bearcats in front 1-0. ACU tried to answer, getting a single and double to open up the home half of the inning. McLeod would follow with a strikeout of Barnhill before walking Kayla Keeling to load the sacks with less than 2 outs. Pinch hitter Savannah Rendon for the final out to keep the Cats out in front. The Cats were not as fortunate in the 6th. Barnhill connected on a 0-1 pitch for a homer to straightaway center field that proved to be all the runs that the Wildcats would need. Sam Houston does not have a midweek on the schedule the rest of the way and can now turn its attention to its final 6 league games, all to be played at home. That stretch will kick off on Friday when it hosts Southeastern Louisiana in a doubleheader set to begin at 3 in the afternoon at the Bearcat Softball Complex. The Sam Houston State Bearcats split a doubleheader against Abilene Christian on Friday at Poly Wells Field. Lindsay McLeod, 12-9, carried the load with a 7-strikeout complete game in the opener, only allowing 4 hits to propel the Cats to a 3-1 victory to run the Cats' win streak to 6 in a row. Annie Bailey would follow that up with a 4.0 innings pitched, allowing 6 runs on 9 hits and no walks, with Darby Fitzpatrick entering the relief for the Cats. Megan Crosby had the game-winning 2 RBI single in the 6th inning in the opener for the Bearcats, while Bailey White crushed a 2-run homer in the bottom of the 7th inning in the nightcap game to try to lead them back to a late rally. The Bearcats will close out the series with the Wildcats on Saturday afternoon, with first pitch set for noon from Wells Field. And Fabian Getward has been named Southland Conference Women's Tennis Player of the Week after leading Sam Houston to a pair of 6-1 league victories over New Orleans and Southeastern Louisiana Saturday and Sunday, April 14th and 15th. The league office announced Getward as the weekly award winner on Tuesday. Southland Conference Players of the Week are presented by University.com. The victories up the squad season record to 12-5 and move the Cats into fourth place with the Southland race with a 7-3 mark. The 12 wins this season tie the program record for victories in one season. Sam Houston already has clinched their 2nd consecutive trip to the Southland Conference Tournament under the direction of second-year head coach Rob Hubbard. Sam Houston needs a victory in its final regular season contest Saturday at Nichols to nail down a top-4 seed in the tournament. The Bearcats rolled up a perfect 9-0 record at the McAdams Center this spring. That mark ranks as Sam Houston's first unbeaten home season in more than 30 years at the NCAA Division I level. Getward becomes the 2nd Bearcat to earn the weekly award of the season. Sam Houston women's tennis team is looking to make 13 a lucky number on Saturday when their Bearcats complete their regular season schedule versus Nichols. A victory would be the 13th for the Cats this year, which would be a new school record. Sam Houston currently ranks as one of the 7 Bearcat teams that have posted 12 dual match wins in one season. This year's 12-5 mark joins the other 12 win slates. First serve at the Colonel Texas Complex is at 1 p.m. A victory also earns Sam Houston a top-4 seed in the upcoming Southland Conference Tournament in Beaumont on Friday through Sunday, April 27th through the 29th. Sam Houston, 7-3 in league play after a pair of wins at home last weekend versus New Orleans and Southeastern Louisiana, now stands alone in 4th place in the Southland Conference race. Since the league expanded to more than 5 teams in 1992, Sam Houston earned a top-4 seed in the tournament only twice before. Saturday's match at Nichols originally was scheduled for April 7th, but was postponed due to rain. 2 other league contestants wrap up the 2018 season slate as Stephen F. Austin travels to the Incarnate Ward and A&M Corpus Christi takes on Northwestern State in Louisiana. Sam Houston leads the all-time series with the Colonels 18-9. The Bearcats have won the pair's last 2 meetings by scores of 6-1 in Huntsville last spring and 5-2 in Thibodaux in 2016. Central Arkansas's Tyler Gray turned in a brilliant start on Friday night, leading the Bears to a 13-2 win over Sam Houston State in the opener of a three-game series at Don Sanders Stadium. The UCA starter went the distance to move 5-0 for the season, striking out seven Bearcat hitters to add to his league-leading total. He didn't allow a hit until the sixth inning and kept the Cats off the scoreboard until consecutive two-out hits in the ninth by Blake Chisholm and Clayton Harp kept Sam Houston from being shut out for the first time this season. Sam Houston was not able to dig itself out of an early hole after UCA got three runs in the opening inning before building it up to a 7-0 advantage through four frames. Hunter Strong and Will Hancock had four hits apiece for UCA, with Strong finishing a home run shy of the cycle. The Bears would finish with 17 hits on the night and leave 17 runners on base, taking advantage of a night that saw Sam Houston issue a dozen free passes. Despite the loss, though, Sam Houston maintains a two-game lead over UCA in the Southland Conference standings, entering Saturday's swing game in the series. First pitch on Saturday is set for 3 p.m. at Don Sanders Stadium.
These boys are just grinders. They're just going to keep playing and playing and playing and playing. The opportunity presented itself, and we took advantage of it. The star of the game, though, is Seth Ballou. He got punched right in the face in the first inning and did not flinch, didn't back up. He just kept coming, settled in, got four pitches going, and was able to get us all the way into the seventh. So that game is on him right there. I'm super proud of that performance. You get a hot ball club like that with every time they swing the bat, something's falling. And it'll take a toll on you psychologically, and they're making every play. You just got to stay with it, stay with it, stay with it, and that's what we did today, and that's what great teams do.
The Sam Houston State Bearcats put up four runs in the fourth inning, and Hayden Wisniewski logged seven strong innings as the Cats picked up a 7-3 win over Central Arkansas on Sunday afternoon at Don Sanders Stadium, clinching the series win against the Bears. It's the sixth consecutive season win to open up Southland Conference play for Sam Houston, keeping them unblemished in league series at the Don under head coach Matt Deggs. It also keeps the Cats on top of the SLC standings with a month left to play in the regular season. Wisniewski picked up his third victory of the season, carrying a no-hitter into the sixth inning before the Bears finally scratched the scoreboard on him in that frame. In all, he would strike out four and allow three runs in his stint before tossing the final two innings. Mills struck out each of the first three hitters he faced, working out of an eighth inning jam to pick up his 10th save of the season. In all, SHSU pitchers allowed just seven hits to the Bears in the final 17 innings of the series. Offensively, though, five Cats finished with a pair of hits led by Hunter Hearn. Andrew Frigier added a pair of hits and an RBI, as did Clayton Harp. Sam Houston will go on the road for the seventh Southland three-game series to face off against McNeese, with the first game on Friday at 6 p.m.
I mean, anytime you can get something rolling like that, it helps everybody else behind you. So, that gives everybody else in the lineup some confidence, you know, especially with the people on base. And we just came up with a big hit tonight. So I thought they were going to walk me, but he came two fastballs in and smiled at me. I kind of figured what he was going to do. So I just started hunting inside part of the plate, and he gave me another pitch inside, and I did what I was supposed to do with it.
Junior sprinter Chris Jefferson was named the Southland Conference Men's Track Athlete of the Week. Jefferson continued his incredible junior season with a big weekend on the West Coast at both the Azusa Pacific Brian Clay Invitational and the Beach Invitational at Long Beach State. His time of 20.66 in the 200 meters set a new meet record and set a new mark for the fastest time in the SLC this season. That day, he also helped the Cats win the 4x100 relay in a meet record time of 40.07. A day later, he helped the Cats lower that 4x100 time, dropping it to 39.99, the winning time for the day at the Beach Invitational and the third fastest time in Sam Houston history. He also ran on the 4x400 relay at the Beach Invitational, leading them to a second-place finish. Jefferson already owns the fourth fastest time in the nation in the 100-meter, running a 10.08 on March 28th at the Clyde Littlefield, Texas relay. With 18 holes in the books, the Sam Houston men's golf team leads the Southland Conference Golf Championships after a 289 team score. The Cats will take a six-shot lead into Tuesday after shooting one over in the opening round. "It was a great start to the event," said head coach Brant Kieschnick. "We had a great game plan and executed it very well the first 14 holes and just made a few mistakes coming in. Our team came out with a focus and intent to compete well." The Cats have four golfers in the top 10, and all five are in the top 13 of the 55-player field. Jake McRory was cruised through 14 holes and was one under, but he gave up four shots on the last four holes and is ninth at three over par. William Holcomb also dropped three strokes in the final four holes and sits in 13th at four over. In all, the Cats dropped 15 strokes on the final four holes. They still lead McNeese by six shots and SFA by 18. That'll be the grouping for the Bearcats for Tuesday's second round of three. The SHSU powerlifting team traveled to College Station over the weekend to compete in the USA National Collegiate Powerlifting Competition. The group competed in a squat bench and a deadlift. Texas A&M, Oklahoma State, and Texas State, just to name a few, were also in attendance for the weekend competition. The Bearcats did not do as well as they'd hoped, but they're confident on what they need to improve on for next year. Now that the competition is over, some will go into the offseason while others get ready for Power Fest that happens in the summer. Brian Minya, who's been powerlifting for the past 2 years, says that the best part about competing and being on the powerlifting team is that anyone can go on and lift weights by themselves, but when you lift as a team, that's what makes it cool. For the second straight year, women's golfer Hannah Alberto took the runner-up honors at the Southland Conference Golf Championship on Wednesday at Wood Forest Golf Club. Alberto helped the Bearcats to a third-place finish in the championship. "I'm really proud of the girls," said head coach Brant Kieschnick. "This is such a tough golf course, and you can be going along really well, and then it just gets a little off, and you can get behind the eight ball." The Bearcats finished with a team score of 9-16 and were 18 shots behind tournament champions Houston Baptist. Alberto birdied four straight on the back nine to get to four under for the round and put her into the lead. However, a triple bogey on 17 and a bogey on 18 put her two shots back of the leader. "It was pretty amazing today to get to four under on this course is impressive," Kieschnick said. She got a bad break there on 17 and struggled coming in, but to come from four or five shots behind and to put herself in contention, I'm just so proud of her. Alberto was joined in the top 10 by teammate Jenna Phillips, who finished the tournament at 13 over after a 77 on Wednesday. Phillips made the turn at one over for the round and was sitting at the top of the leaderboard, but she dropped four strokes over the next three holes to drop out of contention. And today we have an exclusive heartfelt story on softball player Caitlin Dawson. Take a look.
My name is Caitlin Dawson and I'm a pitcher. Growing up, I was told that I had asthma because when I worked out, I could never quite really keep up with everyone else no matter how much I worked out or how hard I tried. I just always felt slightly behind when it came to cardio and conditioning and stuff like that.
Then we had her checked out. They found out about this heart situation and that it was something she was born with and it was actually causing her maybe not to be able to do so much cardio.
This past summer, so the summer of 2017, I got really sick. And I say sick because when I tried to work out, I immediately knew that something was very wrong. I legitimately felt like I was dying. I tried to go on a run and I remember coming back into the house and falling on the couch, calling my mom and telling her that I needed to go see a doctor. I couldn't walk around really without becoming extremely fatigued, having chest pain and palpitations and all that kind of stuff. When your surgeon has to talk to you about survival rates, that's when you kind of, it hits you that this is kind of serious. It's not really just, you know, okay, whatever. Now my rates were pretty good, but it just kind of hit, you know, when he said, well, the survival rates of this procedure is this and that, then, you know, it was kind of like realizing that once I went under, like, I might not wake up. And that was something that I had to work through leading up to the surgery.
So what we did was, hey, when you get back, everything was when you get back. I think it's, if you get around athletes, I don't want them to think they're, well, maybe you can get back. Okay, I don't know if that's necessary. You want to be real positive about that anyway.
Beginning of cardiac rehab, like, it was a big deal to just walk. Walking was my recovery rehab for a while. And I think that starting to jog and run really was the big test for me because I cannot keep up. So going forward, the sky really is kind of the limit. It just is how much am I willing to work through the pain and the exhaustion and how much time am I willing to put in to see where I can go. Because of this heart problem, even though I didn't know that I had it, it was holding me back physically and there was nothing I could do about that. But once I fully recover and get back from, you know, continue to rehab and get back, I could be better than I have been in the sense that I don't have limitations on myself physically anymore.
And that is all the time that we have for you guys this semester. Thank you so much for joining us this semester and me for the past couple of years. From everybody here at Behind the Bench, good luck on finals and have a great rest of the evening. Signing off.